Disappointing loss. I thought we were the better team. Thought we played better than they did. Give them credit for a couple of breakdowns on our part in the final 2 minutes and coming back from a two-goal deficit, and we had the ball. Made some mistakes mentally, made some mistakes physically, and they put it away in the overtime. And, you know, that's sometimes that's life. For some reason, that's been the life of this team this entire year. And I have no rhyme or reason for it. Everything we did out there today, we practiced extensively every single day. From the first day of the fall to the last day, we work on keeping the ball in the box, what the time counts are, when they count. I think there's a big difference on that last call between 10 seconds to get back in the box and 8 seconds to get back in the box. Just looking at the clock myself and watching it count down, it was 8 seconds and they blew the whistle. And checking it on the film that we have of the game, it was 8 seconds. So, and that's the difference in the game. And give them credit for going down the field and scoring a big goal.
Questions for the student athletes or coach team?
Pat, you had a three-goal game. How disheartening is this loss for you, especially just the effort you gave in the fourth quarter?
Oh, it's very disheartening. To make a comeback like that and then just have mental mistakes be the cause of the loss and they score with 1 second left, it kills the momentum that we did have. And then going into overtime, just, they had the momentum and we're all kind of scratching our heads at what the hell happened. And it's just, yeah, it's disappointing, real disappointing.
How do you go about moving on?
You got to put it behind you. I mean, all we can do is look at the next three games and win out, and hopefully 3-3 in the CAA is good enough to get us into the tournament, and then try and win out from there.
What worked for you guys in that fourth quarter offensively?
Just finding the backside after the first dodge. In the first couple quarters, we were just kind of dodging, drawing the slide, and the ball would die on the backside. But Tim found me a couple times on a couple skip passes through, and I just was able to put the ball on cage and bounce it up high and get it in. So it's made the difference.
Any other questions?
Tim, let's talk about one, you know, obviously tough break again, but one of your best, better games this year. You have mixed feelings, obviously, after the loss of 4 points today and then the loss.
I mean, that one hurt a lot. I don't have much to say.
Coach, can you talk about the play of Travis Love's end?
Which one? Thought he played well. Would have loved to see him made those last two saves. He made the first one and it bounced right to their kid and put it in. So it was it kind of looked like the Delaware game, but I thought he played really well. I thought everybody on our team played well. I thought it was a really, really good effort against a good team, number 13 in the country, you know, and we beat them. We honestly beat them, and, except for 59.1 hundredth of a second.
What was Travis's issue with clearing? It seemed
like
he couldn't find a short.
Yeah, I think he was trying to be too perfect on those couple of times. And made a great play downfield that Matt Lehman made a great catch on. And thought he got slashed by their goalie on that play, but no call. But we kept it and were able to get. But then we ran out of the box after that, you know, and just tiny little mistakes that you hopefully you just work on so much that you just hopefully become automatic for you. But that's why we play these games. That's why it's 60 minutes. Just a hard one, boy. This season's been really, really hard. And we've been in every single game we've played this year. And, you know, we're 0-3 in the league right now. And two of those losses are by a goal. So move on. Penn State next Saturday.
Any other questions? Guys, thank you.
Appreciate it.